first regulatory cue for a rugby pass is hand placement on the ball. The throwing hand should be towards the back of the ball, while the non-throwing hand is guiding the front of the ball. The second regulatory cue is shifting the weight to the back foot. This goes in hand with the third cue of bending the front knee. Both of these movements set the foundation for the power of the pass. The fourth regulatory cue is the hip snap. The snap should be crisp and end with the hips facing the target. The last regulatory cue is the follow-through. Both hands should come together at about chest height, with arms and wrists extended and fingers pointing towards the target. It's time to get the chains out. Is your tongue tied up? 'Cause this is my ground and I'm dangerous. Notice how the cognitive learner has good hand placement and their weight shifted on their back foot, but the front knee is not bent. The follow-through here is incorrect because the hands did not come together at chest height. However, there was an attempt at a hip snap. When compared side by side, it is easily seen that the cognitive learner has faults in the follow-through and leg movements, where the autonomous learner does not. After practicing, the cognitive learner has moved on to the associative stage. Seen here is the correct movements they were doing before, along with the improvements they have made. The first improvement is a slightly better bend at the knee and the front leg. The second improvement is a noticeable change in the follow-through. Both hands are together at chest height as she points to the target. The minor adjustments made during practice led to a significant improvement in the quality of the pass.